Hi guys, in the previous tutorial we talked about Git Remote, which acts as a bridge between Git local and your GitHub repository. So in this tutorial we are going to talk about some more options of Git Remote that we can see. So now I had added a remote by name of First Remote, and we provided this URL in that remote, right? But this is in case you are working on a desktop, or you can say a laptop or a desktop, right? But there is another option by name of SSH on your GitHub repository. So when this SSH will come into the picture, this will come into the picture when you are going to work on a server, when all of your codes are placed on a server and you have to directly access GitHub from your server, and you have to push all your changes from server to GitHub. Then you have to provide this SSH path or SSH key in your remote instead of HTTPS URL. So I'm going to create, however I will not be able to use this SSH key because I am not connected to any server as of now. But I am going to show you how to put this SSH key under a remote, which is similar like we did for HTTPS URL. So I am writing git remote add, and this is second remote and the SSH key that we have copied from GitHub, and press enter. And now we can see we should have two remotes. How to check? Just write git remote and enter. You can see now we have two remotes, first remote and second remote. But how to check which remote has what URL? Maybe second remote, maybe you have forgotten that second remote has HTTPS URL or it has SSH key. So how to check that thing? You have to write git remote minus v, and it will show you all the URLs or SSH keys that you have entered against each remote. So for first remote, this is the HTTPS URL for fetching the data, and this is for pushing the data, which is similar. Similarly for second remote, we have a SSH key which will be used in case you are working on server, right? Then only SSH key will be working. In case you are working on a server and you try to push your changes by using this remote, then it will give you certain errors, because between server and GitHub there is a SSH key which acts as a bridge, which tell the GitHub that this is the SSH key which came from this server, then it will accept your changes, right? So that's all what I should be explaining about Git Remote. In the next tutorial we will be pushing the Git changes to GitHub, so we will use this remote to push our changes to GitHub. So that's all in this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please subscribe and like my channel.